been a few months of no updates. So now we're between ripping out and some new stuff being fitted. Let's have a look at the design that we've been working on to refit our 2003 AATS Bravo double-decker coach. These were configured with a number of different styles, ours being a 12-meter long version with 78 seats and a downstairs toilet, and there's a massive cargo hold at the back. It spent its life and a few color changes ferrying around UK holiday makers, and later in its life, school children back and forth school and then school trips to France and whatnot. Now we have it to turn into our mobile self-contained house. It's going to be a lot of work to convert it, but by the end, we're planning on it providing us all of the power, comfort, and space that we need to live and work for a couple of years while we travel the UK and Europe and all of the places that then being on the continent opens up to us. Before we get to that point, though, there's a lot to do. So we'll start by having a look at the outside. There's three main changes that will be made to the outside, one of which you can probably notice by its absence. There's going to be a large amount of solar panels to mount on the outside of it, and there's several doors that are in places where they shouldn't be, and one door that's not even in this model. So the first biggest change is the removal of the rearmost portion of the top deck, which, with a new wall to build and waterproofing of the floor, will give us a small balcony. It's a fairly late decision to do this, but having looked at the structure and other examples online of this bus in a similar configuration, and the fact that I'm 6'2" and have very limited headroom upstairs, it'd be nice to step outside and have a bit of a stretch. It should be easy to cut off and remove the section and waterproof the floor. It's not that complicated a structure, it's just steel tube, aluminium skin, and glass windows, all of which can just be cut out and just pushed off the back. After we obviously waterproof and fix up the wall. The roof space is going to see the next big change with 10 solar panels to be added to it. This is one of the must-haves of the overall plan to be able to power everything we need to, heat everything we want to, and run air conditioning. We need a lot of energy coming from the sun, which will be the primary source for all of the systems. Having limited space on the roof because we've effectively removed some of it, the solar panels will need to be packed in. So that is quite a critical piece of framework that's been designed for it. But all of this we'll cover in a future video. As I record this now, all of these panels are fitted, the bracketing's all up on the roof. There's been some setbacks, which you'll probably see. But for now, it's working and it's just as it should have been, just as it was designed to be. Early on, we removed the skylights, which were old and leaking, and they allowed us to be able to put this amount of solar on the roof. So there's the roof is all flat aside from just the panels that are on it. But they also need to be really close to the roof as possible to keep the overall height of the bus in the legal limits of 4 meters. This is a tall boy. Okay, enough of the outside. Let's have a look on the inside. We'll start with the ground. So the cargo hold at the back, kitchen and dining area in the middle, and then the front of the bus would be the end closest to us. That is the driver's area and the passenger seats, of which we were keeping four, five including the driver. I'm sure we'll recover the seats and make them less ugly than the standard UK coaches. In the centre of the ground floor, looking at the plan here, because the bus is so large and we've got so much space, we can afford to use full-size kitchen appliances. So the fridge freezer, which would go there. We have an air con or space for an air con just above it, indoor unit. A large sink, normal size kitchen units underneath, a full size induction cook hob, and then a really large preparation slash worktop area. Underneath that, the washer dryer and a dishwasher. And then there's space in the wall to the side of the kitchen for the oven, which at the moment has just got an access hole that gets into the cargo bay. And of course, there's the coffee machine on its own little pedestal, because what would it be Instagram without pictures of coffee being prepared from a bus? But that is the kitchen. The colours, again, not being confirmed just yet, and no doubt these appliances will be covered up. If we slide on to the back of the design now, this is the cargo hold, which is a huge space, and as cool as it would be to have a secret tactical security center. Or we have to carry boring things like water and electrical systems to keep humans alive. So, unfortunately, we have to accommodate all of those systems. We don't want to do without a flushing toilet and, if possible, a bath with hot water. So, you have to have enough water to be able to fill a bath, you have to have enough energy to be able to heat the water, and you have to have enough storage to flush toilets and drain sinks and showers and the bath itself. We have here what we think we can fit in the cargo hold, 800 liters of fresh water, which should allow about 4 days of normal use. That's obviously not including using the bath every single day, but showering, flushing toilets, washing, cleaning, drinking, cooking, etc. It should give you a very liberal use of water with 800 liters. If you were to be conservative, you could probably make it last for a week or even several weeks. Aside from the potable water, there will be wastewater that gets generated by the shower, sinks, the dishwasher, washing machine, etc., and that will all need storing. So the system that we've got devised for that is a small filter which all of the wastewater will be gravity fed into, and then this will be pumped up into the storage container at the back, which is that container there. Now we think we can hold about 410 liters in the grey water storage, which would be about 3 to 4 days to fill if you're not trying to be efficient with water. And again, you could probably stretch that out to a week or several weeks if you're really conservative with how you use your water on the bus. And that leaves the one of the last tanks, it's the black water tank. So to support having a normal flushing toilet, this means that you would have to liquefy and store the waste from the toilet. So that would mean the toilet has to be a macerating type, which will then pump into this black water holding tank. Now, if we were to get a 310 litre waste tank for that, that would be about 7 days' worth of flushing toilets before having to dump it again. We found now two smaller indirect and electrically heated water storage containers which will fit in the cargo hold. So it may be that we end up having these two either side, which will be hot water storage, but would also be indirectly heatable. Indirectly heatable? Indirectly heated from the diesel heaters, which we will be fitting in here as well, which are not pictured at the moment. Having hot water storage tanks that are electrically heated means that we can use dump loads for the solar. So, in the event that the batteries are fully charged and there's still plenty of sunshine outside that is not being used for other systems on the bus, the heaters in these can be turned on to allow for a dump load for all of that excess energy that would ordinarily just be wasted. So trying to make the most of the solar system that's on the roof and redirecting energy into that will mean that we should be able to keep a good amount of hot water storage. So in the top deck, we've got the balcony, which we'd already seen. This will give us a welcome bit of unlimited headroom and could give easy access to the roof, which is quite tricky to get to when it's 4 meters from the ground without using ladders and scaffolding. So it'd be good to be able to use this to get up to the roof and look after the solar. The doorway there leads us into the first space that we've got, which is a small lounge slash spare bedroom. There's going to be a big TV in there, of course. And the aircon indoor unit for this area will be there. There'll probably be some kind of sliding door that takes you through into then the stairwell that comes from the downstairs. And the office desk, nice deep desk so that we can work and have some space to kind of sit at. And then just in front of that, we have my poor attempt at modeling some clothes to show what a wardrobe might look like. And then just on this wall, we have another aircon unit, at least the planned location for an aircon unit. The opposite side from there is the shower slash bathroom, which we've designed in a sunken shower tray. The benefit of sinking the shower tray like this is that then, as long as it's all waterproof, which as it will all be tiled, it should be, we can also then use it as a bath. Next to that is the bathroom with the macerating toilet, as we said, and a hand basin. Nothing much else going on in there. It's probably going to be some storage that we'll build into it, and again, it will all be tiled and water, like a wet room style. And that brings us on to the very front upstairs, which we've got planned for the bedroom, with another indoor aircon unit up there, and probably no doubt plenty of storage around. And this was the last must-have, which was a proper full-size double bed. This will be at the front, and you can see by the headboard, the idea is that you'll be sitting in bed and you'll get to look out over whatever view hopefully we're parked up near. This really takes advantage of the windows that are upstairs. This, if we look at this side of things, so we've got this very low section and a huge curved front windscreen, which, I can imagine that's going to be gorgeous. The TV is going to be movable and it's going to go tuck itself up into the ceiling when it's not being used. But that's it. The first thing that's going to happen that's been filmed already is the installation of all of the solar stuff. That's all been filmed, it's just being edited. There's a lot of other things that have been like filmed that I just haven't had the ability to edit yet. So with that being said, I will leave this renderer a graphic.